guys, I hope everyone's having a fabulous day so far. So recently on YouTube, I've been seeing this really fun trend where people answer assumptions about themselves, and I thought, you know what? This sounds hilarious and fun. Let's go, let's do it. So that's what we're doing here today. So I asked you guys to send your assumptions in about me on Instagram, and you guys went in. I haven't read all of them. I did have like a mild glance at them when I was pulling them up, but that's about it. So it's gonna be a little bit of a surprise for me and for you, but without further ado, let's just jump straight into the assumptions. Okay, so it looks like we're jumping straight into the deep end with the first one, which is, you're still a virgin.
Do we tell them that you're married and you've been married for a long time?
Or do we just let them guess? I don't know. You thought you would never get married. This one is actually true. I never wanted to get married. Like, growing up, that was one of the things I despised the most. Marriage. Never wanted to get married, never wanted a husband, I never wanted a family. I mean, I wanted a family, but not in like the typical sense of having a family. I hated guys, I hated marriage, I hated the whole shebang. It seemed like a pointless thing to me. I'm just like, oh my God, like, you're gonna be with this idiot for the rest of your life. You have to put up with this idiot for the rest of your life, and you're gonna get married and feed loads of people and waste so much money just for other people. Like, why? But then I met Tahel and things changed, and here we are many years later, and I am now married. You get annoyed when someone says anime is for children only. Anime is just another art form, another way of telling a beautiful, marvelous story, and I don't understand why people think it's just for children. Like, hello? Do you not appreciate a good story, regardless in which form it is shown to you, whether it's real people or animation or like stick drawings, like, or like just reading a book? Like, it's just, it's all the same thing. Like, it's not a big deal, and it does annoy me. I mean, I won't say it, but on the inside, I'm just like, oh my God, I'm so damn. You low-key hate sweet things. This is kind of true. Like, I feel like when I was younger, I had a huge sweet tooth. I loved the sugar, and my teeth can like tell you that, because your girl has many fillings and a root canal. And I'm actually going for dental surgery soon to get a tooth professionally extracted because it's broken and the root canal fell through. So I used to love sugar, but now that I'm older, I don't know what happened. I just don't love it as much. I mean, it's nothing to do with my teeth, just in general. Like, when I was younger, my mom would always tell me, when you're older, you won't like all these sugary things. And lo and behold, I'm older now, and it is true. Like, I like my sugar, but immediately after having something sweet, I need to have something salty or savory or like water just to drown the sugar, because it's just too much. And I feel really sick really quickly. So like, I gotta like be careful with how much I eat. Okay, next up, something that I knew was gonna come, and I feel like as I scroll through, there's gonna be a billion more of these questions, so I'm just gonna like whack it out right in the beginning. You're planning to have kids in the nearest time? No, no, no. Look, kids are cute and all, they're adorable, they're mini yous, they're little mini humans running around on this earth, but like, I'm just not ready for a child, and I'm not about to have a child just because they're cute, because that is not why you should be having a child. I don't think me or Tahel are ready to have a child. Like, we ourselves still see ourselves as children, so I can't even imagine us having children. That just seems like a wild, crazy idea. We're not grown up enough for that, so that is gonna be put on pause until we feel ready at whatever point that is. Even if it's in 10 years, that's fine. I'm not gonna put pressure on myself to be like, oh my God, I need to have kids by this age, or I'm gonna be an old mom, because honestly, I don't care about being an old mom. It's just like, I will have a child when I feel ready for it, and now is not the time. Neither is the next few years, so that is all right. All right, next up, we're getting a little bit more deep with the famalam questions. You don't see eye to eye with your in-laws. Sorry, you never mentioned them. And that is false. I know there's like this big stereotype of girls hating their in-laws and having evil in-laws that plan like sneaky things, but honestly, my in-laws are really, really nice to me. Like, my sister-in-laws, my brother-in-laws, my mother-in-law, my father-in-law, they are all incredibly nice. And even like Tal's extended family, like his cousins and stuff, everyone is extremely, extremely nice to me. And I think we have like a really, really good relationship. Just, it's great, it's fabulous. I know I don't talk about them a lot, but in general, if you look at my social media, I don't tend to talk about my family that much. I like keep my family private. You choose to save Tiger Lily over Tahel. Probably true. I love my cat a lot, and you know what? Tahel can survive on his own. It's fine. He's a strong boy. He knows what he's doing. If my Lily Bean is ever in trouble, I will save my Lily Bean first. She is my number one priority. You're a legend. True. You are the baby of the group. False. I am not the baby of the group. So in a little friendship group, Tahel is the oldest, then it's my best friend Farah, and then it's little old me, and then it's my best friend Fatima, and then it is my best friend Labli. We literally just celebrated Fatima's 25th birthday, and Labli's birthday still isn't even here yet. By the time she turns 25, literally like a few months later, we all turn 26. Like, just this, yeah. I'm basically one of the oldies, and generally in my family as well, I'm like the eldest cousin, and I'm the eldest sister. I'm just the oldest of everything, or usually in the oldest group of stuff. You're actually shy? I don't think so. Like, There's times where I choose not to speak because I don't want to, but I don't think that's necessarily me being shy. I think that's just like, I don't want to do it. Just, I'm not in the mood to be speaking to human beings. I'm just like, humans, no. But I don't think I'm actually shy. Like if someone forced me to speak in front of people, I'd be completely fine with it. It's just, I'd rather someone else do it, but if I have to do it, it's fine. I think mainly it just comes down to laziness, probably. You're a positive person and you're good at blocking out negativity in your life. I say this is true. I mean, for the most part, like whenever anything negative happens, I'm just like, yeah, it's okay, it's fine. I'm gonna focus on the positives, negatives, be gone. I mean, obviously there are those times where I'm just like, I get a bit sad and a little bit negative, but for the most part, I'm pretty positive person. I think so anyway. Like, I feel like when a lot of people get upset about things, I'm just like, honey boo, chill, it's fine. The weather is bad, it was meant to be like that. Or you broke your shoe, it was meant to be like that. Also, one of my mottos in life is you live and you learn, which basically means if anything negative happens, you're learning from it, which is basically a positive experience. So yeah, you're a morning person and you're very talkative and smiley even at 6 a.m. Hell no, honey boo, hell no. I think a while back, my sister tried waking me up in the morning and I was literally just like, get out of my room, I will kill you. You struggle to get along with some family members because you're much more westernized. With this, I'd say it's like half and half. Like a lot of my close family members, like my uncles, my aunties, and like basically my close family, they're pretty chill, they're quite open-minded, so we don't really have any problems. I think it's my like external family, they're the ones that are just like, oh. You know, the kind that sort of side-eye you from a distance and like, you know, do their little whispering in the corners. I think with them, it's like, it's not like we don't get along, they'll never say anything to me, mainly because they know I will say something back. I am that child. I'm the one that couldn't be controlled, that will just say things as they are. So I think for the most part, people just don't say things to me. Like if they have any thoughts, views, feelings, and opinions, they'll keep it to themselves or speak about it with other people, and then I'll hear about it and then I just get mad and I'm just like, why? Speak to me. You got a problem with me? Speak to me. Let's fix this problem now. You're the type of person to invest in others, making it your goal to make others happy, even if you're not. That is true. Like, I don't know whether it's like an older sibling thing or what, but like I have noticed with myself, like I think I always do it when I was younger, like with anyone around me, it's just like I'd always try and make them happy because I feel like them being happy would make me happy and would just make everything more relaxed and calm, and you know, I just wanted like a nice, happy, calm environment. And obviously if someone is upset or not happy, the environment is disrupted and I just need everything to be chill and calm and awesome and relaxed. And even now that I'm older, I do the same thing with literally everyone. Like I will go above and beyond to make someone happy and to make things perfect for someone, even if it stresses the shit out of me, which it has. Like I've had days where I'm just like, oh my god, I literally cannot cope with this, what is wrong with me? And my friends will literally just be like, can you just calm down and relax and like ask for help and just like take a step back? Because I don't know, sometimes I literally just can't let go of that. I don't know what's wrong with me. I mean, it's a good thing to want to make other people happy, but at the same time it's very important to think about your own happiness and how much you can cope with and you can do. So yeah, little tip for everyone out there, help people, but like don't go out of your way to make someone happy if it's making you sad or if it's stressing you out or it's upsetting you. You approach your man first. This is true. I did. I was the first one to initiate like a friendship and then like a hangout session and XYZ, everything else. I mean, he was the one who asked me out. I was going to do it. I kind of actually already did. I mean, I asked him to the winter ball. How much more obvious could you get? But yeah, I guess deep down in the end, he did ask me. I take it as a win for me. Okay, so I think I'm gonna read one more because I feel like this video is just gonna get really, really long if I read them all. So the last one I'm gonna read is, you're embarrassed to speak Bengali. This is sadly kind of true. Like when I was younger, I was like super embarrassed speaking Bengali because I had like this weird almost self-hatred for Bangladesh. That's like a whole other video in itself, to be honest, to go into. Obviously now I'm not like that at all. It's just when I was younger, things happened. I'll just leave it there, okay? So yeah, when I was younger, I was embarrassed on the whole level of like, oh my god, people gonna think we're weird. Like, oh my god, Bangladesh is so weird. They're gonna think I'm an alien. Like, I already had like one of my so-called best friends literally call me a drug addict and a druggie because she saw me bring into school like this little Bangladeshi jelly. And she was convinced it was drugs and she spread a rumor within like all the students and all the classes. And like, even the teachers are just like, oh my god, Simon, what do you have? And I'm just like, it's literally a jelly, a lychee jelly. Have you never heard of jelly nor lychees? What is wrong with you? Either way, it was a very horrible experience. I don't know, where was I going with the story? Ah, embarrassment. So yeah, I was like really weirdly embarrassed of Bangladesh. Now that I'm older, the embarrassment has kind of shifted. Like, I'm not embarrassed of Bangladesh or like of the language itself. I'm more embarrassed of myself because I'm just like, because I can't speak it properly, there was a time where I was 100% fluent. Like, I was literally so good at speaking, like, Bengali. I was like, yes, girl. Bengali queen. But obviously, now that I'm older and I haven't spoken it for so many years, I've forgotten a lot of it. So sometimes it's really broken, and sometimes, like, I can't, like, I'll just forget words. Like, if I hear the words again, I remember it. But that's basically why I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed because I feel like I'm a failure in the language, and it's my fault. So, like, whenever I speak it, I'm just like... Like, that's literally how I act when I speak Bengali, because I'm just like a little quiet mouse, just like shyness. That's what it is. It's like a little bit of embarrassment and shyness. I mean, earlier I did say I wasn't shy, but I guess if there's anything I do feel shy about, it's speaking Bengali. It's like embarrassment and shyness wrapped up into one. But yeah, guys, that brings us to the end of this little assumptions video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And also, thank you guys for sending in these assumptions. I was honestly kind of scared that you guys were going to come for me, but you guys are really sweet and really nice. So thank you. Just love you. Love you. But yeah, guys, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at saimasmileslike. I post really cool stuff on there. Ooties, fashion pics, like all kinds of fancy jazz, little fun stuff on Instagram stories. Also, by the way, me and my husband both have an Instagram page where we post fashion pictures, which is at @chowmia_. So you want to check that out. Everything will be linked down below. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe and hit that notification button to be notified when I upload new videos. But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you have some fun here, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!